I just want to say that for this video, it wasn't really me trying to like do the Easter egg. This was just me trying to see if I could do it by myself. And surprisingly, I somehow did the first boss fight, and now I just started making this into a video.
I make nasty look good.
Come here anymore, they're gonna hang my picture on the wall.
I don't know how I got that, but that up and down really, really, really helped me out in the in this Easter egg.
My side tonight. I got a lot more life.
those blue rhinos do a lot of damage. If you walk on top of a blue flame while red screen, you're done. You're like Benito.
Hot alien babes. More fuel for the fire.
After that first blue rhino died, I was actually starting to believe myself. I was thinking, oh, you know, if I could beat this one, I could probably beat the other one. But my mind was not in place. Like, I was just like freaking out, and I was still kind of like shaky. But I was trying to tell myself, "You got this, you got this." And of course, that happens. So I was like, "Fudge. Oh no, I'm gonna die." And I was like, no, I'm not dying. I'm gonna take this down with me. Rather, I'm gonna beat this thing, and then I'm gonna move on to the next step. That's what I kept telling myself. And of course, I get red screen again. That's when I started to panic. You gotta be very careful around those blue flames, because, like I said, you get red screen, and you touch him, it's game over. If you're with your teammates, on the other hand, you should be okay, I guess, as long as you all don't die at once. I was very impressed that I did not touch a single blue flame. Well, I did touch one, but I was surprised that Rhino didn't kill me right there and then. Like, my breath, the breath inside of me was just taken away. Like I lost my breath, and I was just like, well, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, and then somehow I survived. For this moment right here, I was very scared because I thought it was going to launch itself at me. But as soon as I turned around, I noticed that there was 4,000 points that came into my screen. So then I was like, oh, is it dead? And then boom, I got this, the cutscene.
You've done it! My goodness, you've finally done it!
Yeah, we've done it all right. We just got one more thing to do.
Unhand me this instant! Give me a moment to explain! Don't you understand what has taken place?
Shut up! We sick of you, your lies, and all this voodoo bullshit!
It's time for a taste of your own medicine, you sick bastard!
You have no idea the magnitude of what you're dealing with! You must listen, or all hope will be lost!
You know what to do, Poindexter.
I beg of you, listen for a mere moment.
Zombies in Spaceland, now starring Willard Wyler.
Please, no!
You'll only make matters
worse than they already appear to be. Countless souls are at stake. We must work together.
Is this nightmare over? Are we finally free?
I don't care to find out. Let's just get the hell out of this place while we can.
It won't budge!
Why in the hell won't it open?
What in the hell is going on, man?
Oh no. What have we done?
God help! Somebody help!
You have served thy master well. Your death was merely the beginning.
As soon as I spawned here into this area, I went to see if I could get Quick Revive again. And I did. For the first boss fight, I'm surprised it took me like about almost 15 minutes in total. That's interesting in my opinion, especially if it's just you by yourself. As soon as I got into the boss fight, I tried to fill up this circle right here, and it was going good, but unfortunately, I got hit by a fireball, and a zombie was in the way, and then I got down, and lost my Quick Revive right away. Once that finishes, I try to like throw little glowing orbs at Mephistopheles, but as you can see, my aim was very potato-ish. I was trying my very hardest, like to try to avoid getting hit by the zombies, and try to hit him while he's trying to attack me. And as you can see, more of them spawned in, so I used my venom to kill as much as I can, grab the max ammo, and then try to throw the orbs at him again. I thought for sure I was gonna die right there and then on the red screen, but I don't know how, but like I guess it was instinct or something. I survived it, and I continued to do what I did. After I threw the last orb at him, it was like time to like attack him. But as you can see, a zombie almost hits me and gets me down, but I was really glad that I activated that venom right there and then. I shoot him, and then I begin to do the next circle. I'm surprised of the red screens I've gotten, and I still haven't died. I don't know how I didn't die, but I guess I just had the devil's luck. this was my bright idea. To walk towards where it's blocked, and there's flames, and while I'm being thrown at fireballs. This, I don't know why I ran towards it, but it was just not a good idea. I'm surprised I didn't die. For this part right here, I tried to lay down on the ground, because supposedly it won't pull you, but as you can see, it almost pulled me. I don't know if it's because I did it wrong, or you just can do it with this circle. Unfortunately for this part, I didn't get him, I missed every shot, and I had to throw the glowing orbs at him again. So what I ended up trying to do was I tried to quickly grab the orbs and throw them at him again. But as you can see, there were zombies right there, so I was thinking, you know what, let me take care of these guys first, and then I'll take care of the big guy right there. And I'm surprised that I managed to do it quickly. I don't even know how I threw those orbs quickly, one by one. But anyways, just to be double sure, I used my candles this time instead of the MHR. And I got him. Unfortunately, for the fourth circle, I got died because of the fireballs, and I immediately leave the game right away to save my fate and fortune cards. I gotta say though, I'm surprised I managed to do three circles by myself in one game. And this was just like, you know, for fun, not for anything like spectacular. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.